Bounce to start the game at the MCG. North Melbourne out of the 5-on percentage and Richmond with just one win in the opening four games. Congested in the middle. Lambert in trouble. Umpire says, your free kick. And Craig Lambert gets the first kick of the match for the Tigers out of the middle. Up to centre half forward. Comes to the front of the pack. And kicked out of defence here by Spargo to centre half forward. Tapped over the back for Schwass's advantage, but he couldn't get there. Bauer beat him to it. Thompson sweeps the hand pass across to Honybun. Back to Thompson. In trouble, Richmond here. Just get out of it. Bauer breaks from the back pocket. Up to the centre of the ground. McCarthy works his way to the front and wins the free kick.
McCarthy, a very good player. Playing at centre half back today. And giving away a few inches to Goodwin. Oh, booming torpedo punt kick right up in front of goal. But what a good mark. That was Michael Pickering, who covers a ton of territory, ducking back to take it. He's going short to his brother. This is Justin. Out wide, he's got it. Now, there's no one in the near vicinity to kick it to. Now he's found someone in Mitchell, and the terrific pace of Mitchell is able to get away to Michael Thompson with a hand pass. So back to Justin Pickering, now back to Thompson. And Thompson right up towards the forward pocket. Out they come. Jeff Hogg was in front. Charging after it is McRae. Also in there to lend a hand was McCarthy. But it's taken away for the Tigers. Lambert with a chance. Goes for the hand pass. Into the open goal. And it looks like a goal coming up to Knights. No, he's just missed. It was Matthew Knights. Charging in. Should have kicked it from there, Bernie.
Yes, bad miss there by Richmond. But North Melbourne should have made better out on that half-back flank. Should have been able to run it over the boundary line, and they didn't. And this allowed Richmond to run it into goal.
Fine conditions here for the match at the MCG. Beautiful sunshine, light breeze. If anything, favouring Richmond in the first quarter. But hardly anything to it. Longmire kicks in. Smith up to centre wing. Hepburn after this with Laffey. And the ball bounces out of bounds and we'll have a throw in centre wing. Both young teams, North Melbourne averaging 22 years of age, Richmond 23, but Richmond averaging less games than North. Just average of 38 games each. Justin Pickering up to Mitchell. Can't take the mark, but at ground level he's good enough. Sprints inside 50. Can pop one over the top. Hogg near the boundary line. Not a bad kick. Great goal.
Very good player, Jeff Hogg. And he is keeping Michael Roach out of the senior side. Well, that was a great goal on that left foot there. He is talking to Richard Lounder, playing his first match for the Tigers today. Giant ruckman. There's a great pace of Michael Mitchell out on the wing. Good chase by North Melbourne. But there's Hogg on that left foot from a near impossible angle. He was able to thread it through.
Lovely goal, as Bernie Quinlan said. Oh, there's German grab when he didn't have it. With a German, very rarely puts in a bad game for North Melbourne. He's in the centre of the ground. I think we're in for a great game here today at the MCG. Some pretty evenly contesting sides. Oh, in front was Laffey. Hepburn trying to take the mark from behind. He's gone out wide. Oh, a crash across the head. Brought down Lambert. Eventually the kick from Schwass comes right out towards centre wing. And over the line, and Spargo and Goodwin having a bit of a dust-up. It's on the true centre wing position. Also coming in for North there is Ben Buckley. The youngster playing in the ruck here, number 45 for North Melbourne, will be Warwick Angus. Now, a kick is from Buckley towards half-forward. Or Clarkson pops it in the back. And no doubt about that. A lot of roaring from the Richmond supporters, but a definite free kick to Clarkson.
Clarkson's kick to centre half-forward. Well, could have been a free kick there to Fairley, but he plays on now. Swashes his body well. Richmond over the ball. The hand pass comes out to Knights. Threaded on past Lambert. He gets a good bounce. Good play by the Tigers. Thompson up from halfback. Long to centre half forward. Hogg climbs. Dumps up the ground. All North Melbourne back there. Martin first to retrieve. Goes for the boundary line. And wins a boundary throw in. Richmond 1-1, North yet to score. North having started clear favourites.
Michael Martin, a greatly improved player this year for North. wearing number four, former champion Ross Glendinning's number. Now that's Lounder, Richard Lounder, getting it down to Egan. Egan in front of the Melbourne member stand, a good one. Back it comes to Egan. Egan, a clever little chip pass across to Lambert, who marks it half forward. Richmond looking good. They started particularly well in the last match against Hawthorn until they were overrun late in the game. There's the kick up towards full forward. An easy mark taken down there by Angus. Now it's a free kick though, I think. In the meantime, for some shepherding out, Peter Cameron said, against John Law. And it will be a Richmond free kick to the...
Here it is again,
Pete. We'll see it in replay.
Well, I thought John Law was entitled to stay on that line.
Well, this is Lounder, Richard Lounder. Big man, 116 kilos he weighs. In his first VFL game, coming from South Australia, from directly in front, 12 metres out for the Tigers second, and he kicks it straight through the middle.
Well, that was rubbing salt into the wounds there, because Johnny Law also caught one high from Richard Lounder when he was going for that mark. And I don't think it was... Let's have a look at that one again. Here it is, Johnny Law in front. And I think he was just leaving it for his man to take the mark, and Lounder ran into the back of him. I don't think that was really a case of deliberate shepherding.
Normally it's a hard way to win a free kick, but it's a very hard way to give one away. Angus beaten out of the middle by Honybun. Free. Boot to ball, but kick smothered. Honybun again, number 42. Shuffles the ball out. Here's Allison. Pass inside half forward. Wide for Fairley. On the 50, on the boundary line. He goes out, ball stays in. Arceri will get a free for that.
Pretty vocal Richmond crowd, Drew.
Okay. Mark Arceri too far out to score. He'll be looking for a tall man to mark on the forward line. Big climb, but no mark there. Big pack. Out of there by Free. Justin Pickering.
Looking good, the Tigers. Justin Pickering transferring play out wide to Phil Egan. He's got it too. He brings it towards the half forward line. Good one. Well done by the big man, but he can't screw it round enough to keep it in play, and he puts it out of bounds on the full. There he is, Andy Goodwin, former VFA player. Penalty kick to be taken down there by John McCarthy. He's giving away, as I said earlier, a lot of height to Goodwin. A number of flyers. Honeybun was one of them. Egan waiting at the bottom of the pack. Back it comes towards McKellar, that beats he and Hepburn over the line on centre wing.
Honeybun doing the rucking for the Tigers, with Lounder propping in the forward pocket. And he's already kicked a goal, Richard Lounder, in his first VFL game. This comes to Knights. Hand pass up and down in the one spot. Goodwin off the left boot. McCarthy, his opponent, to pick up. Good kick on the turn by McCarthy to half forward. Hepburn over his back. Chance for Schwass. With him is Bauer. Oh, Schwass overruns. Bauer uses his body well. Schwass comes back. Turns into trouble. Crowd calls for holding the ball. Bauer hand pass. It's tough in there. Knights caught in the tackle by Buckley. Umpire said ball held to him, and he's going to ball it up.
Well, as Drew said, pretty tough in there. The two umpires today, that's Peter Cameron, very experienced umpire, and Shane McDonald, a very promising young umpire on the way up. That's Shane McDonald. As we see Honeybun trying to get it down. Bauer was there, and also Michael Thompson. Jason Love is there. Lambert also going in. Now he's got, he's a good player, Craig Lambert. As under trouble, he heads back for the boundary line and puts it over about 30 metres around from the behind post. We're on North Melbourne's forward zone. They could do with a goal, because Richmond have the first three scoring shots on the board, and they're a total of 13 points to nil. Now, hand pass comes across to Spargo, a long kick right up towards the pocket, comes off the hands and through for the first score for North Melbourne. In fact, it was Ross Smith who kicked that, not Spargo. 2-1, plays a point, Richmond in front.
Kick into halfback. Contested mark, Richmond's way to Honeybun. Slips out the hand pass to Free. His kick short of half forward. tapped on cleverly. McCarthy first back there. Nest of Tigers though. Mitchell puts it wide for McKellar. Nobody on him. McKellar can run into an open goal. He goes for the pass rather than the score. Hogg one fingernail to it. Over the shoulder, free kick to Hogg.
And I think he might have been held there too, there by Longmire.
It was actually the wrong decision by McKellar. I think he should have had a shot at goal. Just having a look at that, I don't think there was much in it, but Hogg with the free kick.
Well, Jeff Hogg has already kicked one. To give the Tigers a pretty handy break. He shouldn't miss here from 15 metres.
So two goals to Jeff Hogg. Very impressive player for Richmond up on that forward line. Only a young player, but holding down that full forward position, keeping Michael Roach out of the side. There's that kick from McKellar. Went for the centering kick, but that was nothing in that. Oof. Very stiff there. Longmire.
Well, that's two free kicks they might have been lucky to get, but they're both resulting in goals. Three goals the difference. Richmond, a terrific start. It did this against Hawthorne, of course, played well early. There's Hepburn tapping it on. Straight to Michael Thompson, though. Quick kick finds McKellar. McKellar go, oh, here's danger because the pace of Mitchell is there. Michael Mitchell's got it. Clever hand pass to Egan. Egan straightens up. Is this another one? No, he's just missed. Just floated away. Oh, dear, they're playing well, Bernie.
Oh, it's been a great opening by Richmond. And North Melbourne are really struggling to get it past that half-forward line. But the running play of Richmond's smaller men is cutting North Melbourne to pieces.
Well, they've got Jimmy Cracker and, of course, Larkin out. That'll make a difference.
I'll say, to give you an idea of North's, well, North are inexperienced, but so are Richmond. Egan's the only player in their lineup who's played over 100 games, and today he's playing 115. Here's Martin, half-back flank. Kick over the wing. Hepburn charges at it, didn't quite reach the contest. There he is, 34, to tap out to Arceri. Kick by Arceri to half-forward. That's clever play. On to Schwass running past. North first goal coming up. Beautiful play by North.
Yeah, not before time either. The goal of Schwass, who was just about best on the ground last week over against the West Coast Eagles. A very exciting player to watch. North Melbourne teaming well, getting the ball into the forward line. Good hand pass on, good running by Schwass. The handball come from Jason Love, and Schwass was the player kicking the goal.
I agree with you about Wayne Schwass, Bernie. He is a very exciting player. They needed that one. That's Honybun. But it goes straight to Croco. He kicks it back towards half forward. North should mark this. They do through Arceri. Oh, it's tapped back from Allison. It was meant for Arceri. They messed that up. As we see the hand pass come across from Lambert to Matthew Knights. Knights has gone short to Justin Pickering. He's got an open goal. He steadies from 45 metres, slightly off the side of the boot. Lounder is there. Still a chance for Richmond as they go in after. Good play by Jeff Hogg. Use of the body was terrific there as he shuffles it out. He's looking for McKellar. Wayne Schwass charges through, though, and North are able to get it out of defence as the kick from Buckley, or was it McRae, I think it was, comes right up towards centre wing. He gets it towards Buckley. Buckley to Hepburn. Here's a chance for North Melbourne. Hepburn's gone short. That is a beautiful pass. Well spoiled by Richmond, though. Jason Love tries a banana kick off the side of the boot and puts it out of bounds on the full.
Well, he had a little bit of time to steady there. He never even looked like he was going for goals, Jason Love.
Lambert takes the kick to Bauer. Gains about 15 metres, that's all. Bauer cornered. Centres the ball, which could be dangerous. North pick up. Spargo. Through the ball, said the umpire. Richmond's free kick. Be taken by Knights. Well, he could be forgiven for not knowing a lot of these Richmond players. Very inexperienced lineup. Thump away by McCarthy. On by Martin. Free. Dashes through them. Beautiful play. Kick wobbles up to half forward. North have the numbers here, 2-1. But there's a chance here for Young. Comes out to Free. Free centering kick. Lounder at the back of Law. He's got all the height. Longmire keeps it out of danger. Keeps after it with Hogg. Well played by Hogg. The umpire says that ball's held in. And he's going to ball it up just inside the boundary line.
Well, Michael Roach kicked a number of goals in the reserves today. And Jeff Hogg, of course, would know that. He's holding his place through his own good form in the first, but Roach is there. There's Jeff Hogg again with a quick kick towards full forward, but it should be a mark there to Darren Crocker, and it is. Crocker has had numerous injuries since he started a very promising career at North Melbourne. Now, this is Spargo. He steadies. Oh, he kicks straight in the man, Egan, coming towards him. Spargo good enough to go back and give it to McRae. A quick kick from McRae towards half forward. Oh, one-handed attempt by Honybun. A hand pass comes back towards Buckley. Buckley in after. That could be holding the ball this time. No. Umpire Cameron lets him get away with that. Three has gone to Lambert. Oh, it's taken away from Honybun by Hepburn. That was great play. To Spargo. Oh, dangerous hand pass to German because he was covered. German tapping it on, though. Out wide is Alistair Clarkson. Clarkson ridden into the ground and must get the free kick.
Michael Mitchell giving it away, standing the mark. Clarkson props and kicks short. And the mark to Longmar. Well up the ground. No, it's not Longmar, it's Angus. Warwick Angus. And just his fourth game of football. Mark here to Fairley. Has been a danger to all opposition this year on North's forward line. Kicked six to half time last week at the Wacker.
Yeah, good strong mark here to Fairley in front. Well, he's caught behind, but Fairley holding his ground.
Ian Fairley, stuttering start, distance 30 metres, has kicked the goal.
As you said, Drew, Fairley with six goals in that first half last week, set the win up, I think, for North Melbourne over in the west against the Eagles. Let's have a look at that mark again. Long kick by Angus. Not really leading there, Fairley, but using his strength, good positioning of the body. And there he is finishing it off. So Ian Fairley's been a good player all season for North Melbourne.
7 points the difference. Pretty evenly matched in size. And a good comeback this by North after Richmond got off to a blinding start. There's Honybun with a quick kick towards half forward. McRae runs underneath it, punched away by Martin. Or Ross Smith went for it one-handed. Egan is the Richmond player. Ooh, went in very, very hard. Hand pass from Longmire. Comes out to McRae. McRae to half forward. That was Jason Love trying to crash his way through the Packers. Players dive on top of it. Bauer off the ground to Justin Pickering. Now it's Lambert who's looking very dangerous. Big bandage on the thigh of Peter Wilson. Wilson to Hogg. And Hogg is creating problems down there. He is a very good, quick-moving full forward. Now the short one's on. Possibly could have given that one then, Bernie.
Yes, probably in that situation though, Peter, the North Melbourne picked it up very quickly and could have been a little bit of danger there going for that pass.
Well, he's a true full forward. He's having a shot himself. He's kicked two and he's normally a great kick. Look at that one, straight through the middle.
Yes, a very good kick for goal is Jeff Hogg. So three goals already in this first quarter, playing on an inexperienced fullback in John Longmire. I wonder whether John Kennedy will make a move and move Longmire away from him, because Hogg, once he gets his confidence up, can be very dangerous.
These two full forwards today both started with 15 goals prior to this game for the season, but Hogg's got a break. Three to Fairley's one. Out of the centre for the Tigers by three. McCarthy leads the race. Great athlete, this boy. On the turn, kicks 45 metres up towards the wing. German. Comes down to Arceri. Man stays at front. Wilson. Justin Pickering couldn't take the mark. Lambert feeds Justin Pickering. Off the left boot, wide for Hogg. Longmire with him this time, sees the ball out.
Actually, Longmire has played a couple of very good games this year at fullback. And you can see they're pretty evenly matched in height and size, as up the other end are Leeds and, of course, Fairley. There's Lounder against young Angus. Lounder going in after, or leg was Ross Smith. And Ross Smith will take this free kick almost in the back pocket for North Melbourne. This promises to be a very, very good game. Ross Smith, very tough player. Victorian representative towards centre wing. What a brilliant mark by Honybun. Over to Michael Thompson. Thompson wide. Goodwin in front. McCarthy comes over the top. A hand pass. Further afield to McRae. Cleverly done, McRae. To Crocker. Cop one in the face. Back it comes to McCarthy. Can't get in the hand pass. Oh, cleverly done though as he beats Michael Thompson. Oh, Clarkson ducked the head. That's an easy way to get hurt.
Oh, yes, he was lucky. He's got the free kick, but he definitely ducked into that one. Ooh. Andy Goodwin, the player, charging through.
Well, the player's gone on with a short pass, and it's to Arceri. North Melbourne, you've never got them down. They just keep coming back at you. Whenever you get a break, they keep fighting, and that's all John Kennedy coach sides are like that. Here's a chance for Schwass, the big fly. He couldn't quite take it. Now he's got it, Wayne Schwass. It's smothered off the boot, and Justin Pickering takes it away.
Pickering's kick along the ground through the centre. Goodwin fumbles. Comes out to Egan. Beautiful hand pass away. Free on the run. Puts it wide. Lounder there, one out with Law. And he's got all the height. Well, what chance did John Law have there? He's 185 centimetres. Lounder's 203. And I don't really know what 18 centimetres is in real terms, but it's a lot.
Yeah, just no hope, John Law. With the strength of Lounder also, height and strength, one out.
Huge.
So this could be a pretty good VFL debut for Richard Lounder. Two goals in the first quarter.
116 kilos, Drew.
Could be a professional footballer or a professional wrestler. But if he can kick like that, I suggest he stays with football.
So Lounder's had two kicks for two goals. Was named in the first ruck, but has lined up in the forward pocket with Honybun doing the ruck work. And he's just too tall for John Law. John Law, not really a player who should be moying ruckman, especially ruckman of that size. And Lounder has a very good kicking style for a man his size too, Peter.
Beautiful skills. Well, I don't know what North can really do about that. They're not blessed with a lot of height. That was Peter Wilson with a long hand pass straight to Martin. Oh, he's lost it to Egan. Egan crashes his way through. He's got it. Philip Egan ducking back. Quick hand pass to Goodwin, smothered off his boot by Martin. Crocker tries to fist it away. McCarthy charging after it. Gee, moves well, as Drew said earlier, John McCarthy. Michael Pickering hooks it back, travels about 20 metres towards his brother Justin. Alan McKellar's there. Michael Mitchell also. Mitchell straightens up and kicks it high. Here's Lounder again, sets himself in front. Fisted away from over the back by Longmire. And in fact, the ball goes over the line about 5 metres around from the behind post, but still in Richmond's forward zone.
Richmond shocking North at the moment. 5-2 to 2-1. Lounder palms down. Mitchell might take a free against Spargo. No, the umpire left the whistle away. Now he's going to ball it up. Well, I suppose Richmond have already had two free kicks on the forward line, which have resulted in 2 goals. You can't keep giving them, can you?
Well, they don't pay the fair dinkum free kicks, do they? It was all over Michael Mitchell.
Oh.
Lounder wins this tap again. McKellar goes backwards to free. He's got a bit of time. Now he runs out of it. But somehow gets it away to Michael Pickering. High kick. Hogg comes from behind. Comes out to Mitchell. 20 metres out, that's all. Hooked it. Through for a behind.
Well, there's no doubt, Bernie, he'd have to be one of the quickest... Well, I'd say the quickest player over 15 metres in the league.
I think the pace of this Richmond side overall has surprised North Melbourne.
There's Longmire bringing it out towards the half-back line to Darren Crocker. And Crocker has put it out of bounds on the full. So North not playing particularly well at the moment. They're down by 20 points. We still have 5.5 minutes of play left in this first quarter. This is Michael Thompson on screen, bringing it towards half-four. That's intelligent play. Jeff Hogg up in front. The big man Lounder was over the back. Gee, goes in after that ball too. McKellar looking back for free. It's socket off the ground to half forward, and that should be a mark, and it is. Down at half forward. Now, this is Ben Buckley. He's gone short, intelligent play. He had an option of two men, and he has found Paul Spargo. Now, Spargo is from 60 metres out. Now, let's see if there's a lead or a space for someone to run to. He might even go the long. He looks like he's going the long torpedo punt kick from here. Let's see if he can get onto it. Oh, it's a booming kick. It fades away. And, in fact, he's put it out of bounds on the full.
He kicked that right from the centre square line, so he's kicked that a good 65, 70 metres, Spargo.
Brian Lees to kick in for the Tigers. Big pack over here. Honeybun in front. Almost to Angus. Comes to Allison. Short pass to Hepburn. Hepburn, another short pass. Right in front of goals, Arceri. Man on the mark, 40 metres from goal. Mark Arceri played a top game last weekend in the wet in Perth. This will go close. And I think it might have crept home. Yes.
So a barely needed goal to North Melbourne. And they've struggled in this first quarter against Richmond. Been surprised by the Tigers' tenacity. There's Arceri, the player who kicked the goal. Angus. Good play by North Melbourne into that forward line. The pass here from Hepburn. Arceri on the lead. And as Drew said, he played a great game last week in the West against the Eagles.
19 to 33, Mark Arceri, a terrific little rover. Only tiny, but boy, he can play football. Oh, here comes Wilson. Peter Wilson. Oh, he's lost it. Big chance there to run down into an open goal. Michael Martin looking for Schwass. Good tackle by Schwass. A loose ball is at half forward for Richmond. Off the ground by Buckley. Out wide is Brett Allison. Now let's see if he'll swing onto his left foot. No. He's going onto the right and attempting to go short to Spargo. Now he's run down from behind. A quick hand pass. Comes to Angus. Again, the player brought down from behind. Gee, they're going in hard after that ball. Thompson taps it back. Mitchell to Laffey. Laffey wide. He's looking out there for Tony Free, and he has a touch of the fumbles. Now he's got it. He's at half forward, bring it down, looking for Jeff Hogg. Over the back is Longmire. He charges after it. Now he's got it, John Longmire. Quick hand pass finds John Law.
Law making a return to the north side today, up to centre wing. Angus can't mark. Comes to Smith, who was knocked cold in Perth last week. Two against two on half forward. Comes to the back to Lambert. Tigers looking good in the running game. Wilson. Beautiful pass. Mitchell. He's got McKellar up the ground. But he goes inboard to Knights. Left footer is good from 55. Great kick.
Very impressive for Tigers. Good usage of the ball. Running out of the back line. Their tackling has been ferocious. And also they're winning the ball out of the centre square on most occasions. Hand pass there. Ending up with Matthew Knights. Kicking on that left foot from just outside the 50-metre line. And I think Kevin Bartlett would be very happy with this young Richmond side.
Well, there's a North Melbourne player injured now. Is it Longmire? No, it's not. It might be Ross Smith, I think. Oh, gee, get some injuries, Smith, and I'll certainly miss him. There's Michael Pickering going down towards half forward. And, oh, what a good mark. Beautiful mark at half forward for the Tigers. The short pass comes across to Mitchell. Mitchell's gone short to McKellar. Open goal. McKellar, bang, and it's another one.
Well, there's a loose man on the Richmond forward line there.
Barry Young was the man who took that mark, by the way, Bernie.
Yes, because I was saying, Peter, Ross Smith being injured, they had to wait till he came across the line, and Darren Steele charged on, but he couldn't do anything about picking up the loose man. There's McKellar running around by himself on the forward line. Had plenty of time to run on and kick an easy goal.
Well, for those who took the short odds about North Melbourne, they've been heaps of bother at the moment. It's 7-3. And Richmond looking very impressive. There's a free kick in the middle. Player Helga not in possession. Mitchell. Michael Roberts on the boundary line.
Yes, Ross Smith received a bad knock on his knee, his left knee, and he's in a lot of pain.
Well, he can't seem to take a trick at the moment, Smith. Knights, another good distance with a left footer. Hogg in front, can't take the mark. Longmire gets the hand pass away to McCarthy. He's kicked to half back, looking for Buckley. Oh, beautifully tapped out by Wilson to Mitchell. His kick a bit far. Spoiled by Crocker, and the ball out of play.
Well, North under a lot of pressure There's Ross Smith, as Michael Roberts reported, having that injury attended to down there. But they're looking good, the Tigers, but they started off particularly well. Haven't been playing against Hawthorn last week, and they haven't been playing a lot of games where, Bernie, where they've played the four quarters right out.
Well, that's often what happens with lower sides, Peter, don't they? They can stay with the top sides for two or three quarters and then fade away.
Well, there he is. That's not too bad. That's a good sign, the fact that he'll be jogging around the boundary line. Here's Richmond again. That's Lambert. Quick hand pass. North able to bring it away. John Law to Schwass. And Schwass heads for the boundary line and puts it over.
26 points the difference. Richmond leading with just 15 seconds remaining to quarter time. And they're on their forward zone. They might be able to sneak another one if they can get it cleanly out of here. They might two through Knights. Mitchell chopped off by McCrae. He's caught by Free. The hand pass close to the boundary line, and that will be time. Great first quarter by the young Tigers, and they lead 7-3 to 3-1.
Start of the second quarter here at the MCG. A brilliant opening quarter by the Tigers. They lead 7-3 to 3-1. The ball in the centre of the ground. Wayne Schwass for North Melbourne coming straight down the centre, looking for Ian Fairley. Over the back of the back. Here's a chance for Jason Love. He can't get back to grab it. Now he tries to kick it off the ground. Brian Lees is in on top of it with Brendan Bauer. And it'll be a bounce down right in front of the North Melbourne goal.
Good kick by Schwass out of the middle. It's put North right into attack to start the second quarter. They trail by 26 points after the first term. Snapped by Fairley, offline. And we'll have a boundary throw in. Ian Fairley, not his usual goal kicking form in the first quarter there, just one. Last week in Perth, he kicked four in the first term. Honybun. Still a chance for North. Arceri knocked off it by Wilson. And the ball out again for another throw-in.
Deep in that forward pocket, there's Peter Wilson, who was in doubt during the week, and he does have a huge bandage on his hamstring. There it is. I'm not sure if that's protecting the front of the thigh or the back. Here's a quick kick by Spargo at the goals. That is a magnificent snap. I think this is very close. In fact, it's through.
Great snap by Spargo. Stealing that one because the knockout there by Honybun, who's doing well in the ruck. Spargo positioning himself very well. Not a Richmond player there. He should have been. But Spargo curling that one around. So North Melbourne needing that one badly.
Margin back to 20 points after Spargo's great snap goal. Honybun wins in the middle again. Free. Knocked off it here by Clarkson. Up to Schwass. He's bowled over by Thompson and we'll get a free kick. Wayne Schwass, who won the medal in the under-19s competition a couple of years ago. And the North seniors starting to reap the benefits of their successful reserves in under-19s. Schwass to centre half forward. Comes off hands to McKellar. Over to Wilson. The hand passes 25 metres to Thompson. Thompson to half forward already. That's a free kick Richmond's way. Hogg knocked out of it. That's not Hogg, it's Young. And Young with the free kick.
He moves very well, Drew.
Just an 18-year-old playing in his second game of football. Kicking from outside 50. Floats across, 15 metres short. Thump out of defence comes to Mitchell. Egan's there. Palms it out. McCarthy first there. Clever kick. He didn't go too hard. He bounced it out.
Yes, Drew, you've called it well there because that was intelligent play that was by McCarthy. Clever little kick. Could easily put it out of bounds on the full. It's in that deep in that forward pocket. is Lounder, the big man, doing the ruck work. Quick kick is smothered off the boot by Justin Pickering, grabbed by Craig Lambert. He's tackled, and the ball is forced over the line. It's Dean McRae, who's a pretty tough customer. North Melbourne, can think you have them down at times, they just keep coming back at you all the time. The big fist away was by Angus. Only a youngster, he gets it to Allison. Allison, a quick kick towards half forward. Wilson, a clever hand pass to Honybun. Honybun long and wide looking for Pickering. And Michael Pickering has taken the mark 45 metres out from goal. Now, the short one is on. Pickering goes to Hogg, and that is intelligent forward play by Richmond.
Yeah, set up there with a long kick into the forward line by Honybun. Switch the play to the other side of the ground. And there's Pickering. Good lead by Hogg. Now having a shot from about 40 metres out.
Really have got a good forward set up, Richmond. The way Hogg leads up the ground. They have Lounder back in the goal square. This is going for his fourth, Jeff Hogg. He is a beautiful kick. Straight through the middle.
They look as if they're in a little bit of trouble, North Melbourne, with their setup today. Because they're just not getting that ball out of the centre square. Honybun doing a great job in the ruck. There's a pass again to Hogg. Honybun kicking the ball long into the forward line also, Peter, and he's well on top in the ruck duels.
They must miss Jim Cracker there, North Melbourne, Bernie.
Well, you have a look at their players around the pack and they're just not getting the ball.
Margin back to 26 points after a goal apiece to start the second quarter. Honybun doing well on the ball. Named it centre half forward. Tunnelled out. Umpire pulls play up and is going to ball it up just as Schwass was about to dash away with it. Well, Jeff Hogg already has 4 goals on the board. Last year he kicked 57 goals from 20 games, but occasionally got quite a big bag.
Here's Honybun rucking well to Lambert. To Mitchell, very quick player Mitchell. Now it's Schwass, terrific skill by Wayne Schwass. Towards half forward, Spargo couldn't take the mark. This is Michael Pickering, a quick kick. Oh, punched on by Wilson, was intelligent play. Towards centre wing, this is Michael Martin. Charging after the ball, can he hook it back? He tries, but under pressure from Mitchell, that's the pace of Mitchell. Martin has put it out of bounds on the full.
Wilson takes the free kick. Finds Bauer just behind centre wing. Bauer goes longer. Martin at the front. Hooks for himself and then taps out cleverly to Arceri, who puts the kick to half forward. That's good play. German's been quiet. Off to Clarkson. Short pass for Fairley. Made it tough for him. And the umpire says, you're holding it. Well, I thought he made a couple of attempts to shuffle it out. Free kick taken by Lees.
I agree with you, Drew. He tried to hit that out then. As we see Honybun towards half forward. Oh, this player looks all right. Number 53, Barry Young. On this occasion, he's knocked off the ball by McRae, but he goes in again. McRae, now he's tunnel balled and under his legs. Towards half back, Arceri to Crocker. To Steele. Steele to half forward. Alistair Clarkson, the pretty short player to have to be flying in packs. Now he's lost it to McKellar and he gives it to Thompson.
Michael Thompson breaks free. Puts it very wide. Too wide. Out of bounds on the full. And the free kick will be taken by Mark Arceri in between halfback flank and centre wing. 51 plays 25. Tigers in front. Arceri's kick to half forward. Big climb. What a mark. Dragged down by Honeybun. He's starring.
Well, he was a former amateur champion, ruckman. They tell me he used to take 18 to 20 of those every week. There's Mark Arceri. A quick kick to centre wing. Oh, that was beautifully smothered by young Angus, but it's kicked off the ground to half forward for Richmond. Taken away by Steele. Michael Pickering sets himself in front. Couldn't take the mark. Here's a chance for McCarthy. Beautiful kick to Spargo. What a magnificent piece of disposal that was. And look at the loose man. Schwass is there. Now he's off. Spargo off, good presence of mind to chip it in short, and will be a mark that Jason Love.
They're not playing well though, are they, Peter? They're a little bit undecided with what they're going to do. Indecisive movement of the ball. There's a pass from Spargo, and really Jason Love not moving much either there.
Well, they could do with this one. He's a real goal sneak, Jason Love. He's normally a great kick for goal. He stabs at this one. He's missed, and he has put it through for for a behind. The former star player Jason Love in the VFA in Melbourne with the Port Melbourne Football Club.
Keller kicking in, ignores the bunch and goes for Honybun, who covers the ground and takes another excellent mark. One high, one low in the space of a minute. Schwass in front, but Free gets there. Free's kick up towards half forward. Martin drops the mark, it comes to McCrae. Round the boundary line, chopped off by Lambert. Lambert off the left boot to centre half forward. Michael Pickering steers it low for Hogg. Almost a steal. Comes to Mitchell. He's in front, 25 metres out. Off to Lambert. Lambert hooks it back. Close, but not far enough for behind.
Well, I thought Mitchell was going to get away for sure there with his pace. So it was a good effort by North to bring him down. There's the kick by Longmire towards half back. Oh, Matthew Knight. Beautifully done by the youngster. Comes in on the left foot, stabs a goal and misses, but oh, good skills.
We got some very good young players in this Richmond side. Players that, not with big names, they blooded them last year, and there's Love having a rest, but the Richmond, young Richmond Tigers with plenty of desire.
Jamie Stevenson on the ground for North Melbourne. Hand pass comes to Law, but his kick smothered. Great desperation. That's the full forward doing that now. You boys, did you ever do that?
No. I wouldn't be out that far. Never get back, Drew. He's about 80 metres out from goal, Bernie.
Well, that's good. It's good signs there for Richmond.
Oh, well, this is 1989, of course, and Jeff Hogg is a very good player. He's kicked four. What a great smother that was. There's Mark Arceri getting it across to Schwass. As Bernie said earlier, a very exciting player. DeSpargo. Now, Fairley's been moved from full forward. Hepburn's down there. This is Peter German. Now, well, it's it for him. He's got it. Left foot trying to centre it. Cleverly done as he hooks it back. Jamie Stevenson's on the ground and he's taken the mark. Fairley was there also. Now, can he chip it across? I doubt it. No one there to give it to, so he might have to have a set shot. Stevenson from about 20 metres. Well done by German.
Yes, he was quiet in that first quarter. Coming into the play a little bit more in that second quarter. Good mark there by Stevenson.
Jamie Stevenson, I really could do with this North Melbourne. He's on an acute angle. He's a left footer though. Oh, he's hooked it badly. Never looked like it. And through it goes for a point.
Well, North Melbourne, 7 scoring shots. Richmond, 13. Interesting to look at this bunch at centre half back. Not very far in, actually. It's only about 30 metres in. And they've all fanned out. Pretty close to the boundary line now. Here's a chance for North. Allison overran the ball. Knights gets the hand pass away to Wilson. Up to Lambert. Trouble coming here with Arceri. It goes to Michael Thompson. Off he goes to Goodwin. And a bit of rain here locally this morning. Just a little bit slippery underfoot. He lost it. Picked up by McCarthy. Climbed by Angus. No mark. Comes to Allison. Back to Clarkson. Centering kick is good. Fairley. Well, that's John Kennedy's style, the centering kick, and he goes short. And the mark is taken by German.
Got one right in the gob.
Yep, might have lost a couple of teeth as well as taking the mark, I think. Peter German. Well, it's been an unusual game, German. He's had just 3 possessions so far, and we're midway through the second quarter. Should get a goal and narrows the gap.
I think we're in North Melbourne have missed out. They dropped Venner out of the side this week. They have only got one big man on the ground, and that's Angus. And he's been being thrashed in the centre square bounces by Honybun. And they really haven't got anyone else to throw in there against Honybun. So North Melbourne, with their team selection, may have let themselves down a little bit.
Could be a change on right here.
Yes, I
think Angus coming out of the centre for this one.
And Hepburn in. That's interesting. It must be giving him a spell, I think, Bernie. Young Angus. And Hepburn's a pretty fresh man. Three goals to the difference. They're hanging in there, North Melbourne. He's got a big spring Hepburn as he gets it to Schwass, who's doing well. Here's Spargo again, sets himself. He's got it. Open goal. Spargo, and he holds his head in shame as he misses. Of course, his dad, Drew, Bob Spargo, was a great player many years ago for the Footscray Football Club.
I played with his uncle too at Footscray, Ricky Spargo.
Ricky, very pro runner, wasn't he,
Bernie? That's right, yeah, very good runner.
Bauer sets himself to kick in, but he wasn't happy with the bunch. Now he's got a target. It was a big climb at the back, but no mark. Comes to Lambert. He's caught holding it. The umpire doesn't blow the whistle. McKellar and Laffey fight each other for it. Gee whiz, they might have been just a fraction lucky there, Richmond. And the North crowd think they were. It'll be a ball up.
Well, I didn't think there were that many North supporters here, but they're making plenty of noise about that one. It's about 40 metres out from the North Melbourne goal, and they, as usual, they just scratch and claw their way back when they're not playing all that well. There's Wayne Schwass trying to crash his way through. A quick kick comes up towards half forward. Michael Thompson over the back, charges after it. Former Essendon player couldn't get a cement a regular place with Essendon as he brings it up towards half forward. Goodwin is there. Steele also. It's tapped away. This is Martin. Greatly improved player. Stevenson sets himself. Couldn't take the mark. Thompson shuffles it out, but Mark Arceri doing the roving brings it to half forward. Spargo sets himself up in front, but the mark was all set up down there for Michael Pickering.
He's a great mark, Michael Pickering, for his size. Oh. He just keeps on dragging down the high climbs. And a good pass off to Lambert. Now to Wilson. And Peter Wilson's kick to half forward. Egan with a set. Comes off Martin to Egan. Nobody at centre half forward. Streaming onto this Longmire. Good pick up by McCrae. Dashing out of defence. Beautiful play to set up North. Runners are plenty here if Crocker can gather. Out to Schwass. Good play. Off to Hepburn. He approaches 50. Goes long with the kick. It's got a chance. Just offline. But what a sweeping bit of play that was by North.
That was great play, as you called, Drew. Particularly from McCrae. Brendan Bauer, oh, this is unforgivable, because Wilson is 30 metres clear from any North Melbourne opponent. Onto the left foot, he's hooking it back towards the centre now. Can the youngster get there? This is Barry Young. Gets in a hand pass to McKellar. McKellar centre wing, going for the short one. He was looking for Hogg. Out comes John Law. He trapped that beautifully, Law. And a long booming kick. The centre of the ground, Hepburn sets himself in front. Oh, beautifully trapped by Lambert. Out wide to Matthew Knights. And Knights on centre wing will go. No, he ducks back onto the right. Now onto the left. He's gone short. Finds McKellar. McKellar traps it. Tries to get his boot the ball. He does. Hogg against Longmire. Well done, Longmire. In went Lounder. And taps it over the line.
53 plays 35. Tigers by 3 goals with 11 minutes remaining to half time. Hepburn contesting in the middle and boundary throw-ins at the moment. Mitchell! And that's out of bounds on the full. Thought it might nearly have scored a point. But it'll be a North free kick in to be taken by McCrae.
Dean McCrae. 38 VFL games. In North Melbourne, we talk about Richmond being young. North Melbourne have blooded a lot of youngsters too. A number of them have come up from their good under-19 sides. Oh, Egan, the big fly, and what a good mark for little man. Philip Egan has gone short to Lambert, who's been an excellent player. Lambert back to Egan. Egan in trouble. Caught, holding the ball. Shane McDonald paying that. The short kick from Hepburn comes to Spargo. Spargo back to Steele. Here's a chance for North. The short pass is on. Oh, the mark is dropped by Angus. Should have taken that one. And Tony Free comes out of defence. A quick kick. Finds Hepburn for North. In went Allison. And Richmond, oh, the head is ducked. And he's a bit lucky to get that one, Tony Free.
Free's kick up towards half forward. Another big climb and another mark. Michael Pickering again. He is great to watch. Hogg leading it full forward. It comes in short to Hogg. Beautiful play. And he's got it right on the 50. Well, he was on a pretty long lead. I reckon that was at least a 30-metre lead. By the time the kick was delayed a bit, he found himself 50 metres out. He's kicked four already. Torp well short. Safe defensive mark to Crocker.
Darren Crocker looked like being a superstar early in his career, but numerous injuries he's had. Oh, another big mark. This time by Egan again. Egan bringing it towards Hogg. Oh, strong workers. Players crashing after it. Longmire to Hepburn. Oh, some brilliant passages of play going on here. Hepburn out long to Clarkson. Over the back of Spargo is having an excellent quarter for North. Touch of the fumbles there, but he gets in the hand pass out wide to Schwass. Schwass almost caught by Wilson, but he gets away. He's got great skills. Angus and Laffey. I don't know whether young Angus is good enough to rest down there at full forward, Bernie.
No, I think he's a little bit inexperienced and struggling at the moment.
Honybun the spoil from behind. It goes to Thompson. Over the top to Wilson. Play flowing from one end to the other. Wilson to half forward. Oh, Mitchell hit about a quarter too early then. Steele. Steele's kick to half forward. Oh, courage. Pay that mark for courage alone. Well, he didn't pay anything. It's taken by Lees. Bad luck for Clarkson.
Oh.
Lees' kick bounces through a couple of players. Through Crocker it goes. Off the ground, Mitchell. Comes to McCarthy. Long kick from a standing start to Schwass. Just forward of the wing, Wayne Schwass. Goes to full forward. Fairley in good position. Easy mark.
Well, he's got an option of a couple of men to kick it to. If I was Fairley, I'd go back and have a shot because he gave one away earlier in the quarter. It could have been dicey. Now, he'll only have to kick from 45 metres. He stabs at this. Now, will it get there? It won't. Doesn't quite make the distance. In fact, that was an ordinary kick, Bernie.
Very poor kick by Fairley. I think he just tried to make the distance and that was it, instead of going back and kicking through the ball.
Well, there's a sight. Peter German on the boundary, on the bench, and he's had a very quiet day with just four possessions. Oh, great play here by Clarkson, by Allison rather, into Hepburn who couldn't control it. The hand pass comes back. Spargo running out of room, hooks back well. Stevenson there. No mark, but he's after it again. Scooped off the ground by Love. Back to Schwass, who took his eyes off it, but has time to recover. Snap from 35 is a goal.
All class, Wayne Schwass. And that's his second goal. One of the exciting players in VFL football, only a young player. But already he's just class written all over him. There he is again. Fumbles that one, but he's got... He is a left foot kick, but has time to steady, get back on that right foot, and snap an excellent goal.
No doubt about the class of that man on screen, Wayne Schwass. That was a top goal. 42 to 53, and again North claw their way back into it. They're a good side, North Melbourne, as the kick comes down towards half forward. Right down towards the pocket, mark Arceri's down there. Now, that kick was by Clarkson. They've got a number of these smaller size players that look very similar. Ross Smith being one of them, but he's off the ground. Coming on is Trevor Poole, and off is Andy Goodwin for Richmond. It's deep in the forward pocket for North Melbourne. Over the back is McKellar. Finds Lees with a hand pass. To Laffey. Back to McKellar. That's beautiful defensive work by the Tigers as McKellar. Oh, funny looking kick. It's gone straight towards McRae, who's playing well. McRae. To Clarkson. Alistair Clarkson, a long kick. Jamie Stevenson ducks back. Attempts to take the mark on the second bite, but can't do so.
Just 11 points the difference. After it had been 26 points at quarter time. And North in attack again. Get a goal from this, they'll be within one kick. Laffey goes the punch. Comes to Schwass, who's been a star again today. Spargo may have got one in the back. Hepburn to Stevenson, almost, but it goes through for a behind.
10 points the difference, and gee, they could do with someone to take a mark up there in North Melbourne. They get it up there a lot, but they don't take many marks unless Fairley's taking them. Justin Pickering wide to Michael Thompson. Now Thompson from the half back line kicks long. Over the back was Egan, but North doing well in defence. That was Michael Martin. Oh, terrific play by Martin. has found Paul Spargo. And that was, their defence has really got on top, Bernie.
Yes, I think the move that has helped a little bit, Peter, is Hepburn into the ruck. And they've started to get the ball out of the centre.
Well, Paul Spargo's already kicked one. Now, this is not an easy kick. You have to kick from 50 metres, or maybe even 51 or 50. Well, 52 metres he kicked that from. It's not a bad-looking kick. And that wasn't touched, but it was offline anyway and over the heads of the pack for a point. So 6-8 to 8-5. So the difference now is 9 points in Richmond's favour.
Well, last time Richmond kicked in, Wilson found himself 30 metres in the clear. This time, Michael Pickering not quite that far in the clear. In fact, he doesn't win the ball. Crocker puts him under pressure. Pickering good enough, though, to Laffey. Bauer. Oh, good teamwork. Oh, but Justin Pickering too slow. Caught by Allison. It spills to Buckley. Goes to Schwass. Michael Pickering, a bit quick for Lambert. Oh, it was well done by Angus. Love gets a hand pass away to Schwass. In he goes to 50. Over the top from Arceri. Spargo another shot for goal. And this one misses again.
Oh, Schwass shouldn't have handballed then, should he, Bernie?
I wouldn't have thought so, Peter. He was in perfect position to have a shot at goal himself. But Spargo, that's one goal free for the quarter.
Well, Wayne Schwass was running in on his own, on his left foot. Got an open goal and handball. But there's Matthew Knight's Michael Pickering. Now, was he off? Umpire didn't think so. The short one is on to Egan. No mark. Philip Egan. Oh, good strong play. Martin, a good chase by Martin. Great play. Michael Martin, what a fantastic effort.
Yeah, great play by Martin. Never gave Phil Egan a moment's peace there. And Michael Martin coming out with a free kick, holding the ball against Egan.
Well, North Melbourne definitely coming back at the Tigers. Martin from centre wing. What a leap by Honeybun. How's he playing?
Gee, there's been some great marking, Drew.
Well, he's taken two scorches in this quarter. So has Egan, so has Michael Pickering. And yet North have narrowed the gap. Here's Wilson, up short of the centre of the ground, and Bauer marks.
Brendan Bauer. Plenty of good work around that. Oh, they're getting themselves in all sorts of trouble because North's defence is on top. Now a chance. Oh, two of them nearly got in each other's way. This is young Angus, Warwick Angus. Back to Crocker. Crocker's gone wide. Little Marcus Series out there. I think it'll beat him. And it does. Over the line in front of the Melbourne members stand here with 3 minutes of play left in the second quarter. As we have a look at that Honeybun mark again.
He said himself, had the ride, eyes on the ball and with strong hands. Great mark to Honeybun.
Peter Wilson heads for the boundary line and puts it over. But the scoreboard shows 6-9, 45 North Melbourne. Richmond with their noses in front, 8-5, 53.
Angus back on the ball for that boundary throw-in. Richmond come out with it. Mitchell the hand pass to McKellar. Gee, solid shepherding off the ball, and a couple of players didn't like it too much. Diving mark by Crocker. Well, they've got some space on the far side of you. Don't mind. Look at Arceri here. He approaches 50. Over the top to Schwass. He should kick this one. 30 metres out. Bang.
Richmond can't get that ball past the half-forward line. And get it up there. North Melbourne defenders right on top. And they've had nothing. Goodwin started at centre-half forward, but he's off the ground. Poole now playing at centre-half forward, but still nothing. McCarthy on top, and North Melbourne running the ball very easily out from the defence. And Schwass again kicking the goal. So that's three goals to Wayne Schwass.
Well, you mentioned you can't get it over the half-forward line. Jeff Hogg's out there now, and Egan's gone down to the forward line. 2 points the difference. The Tigers in front. Honeybun beaten for that one by Angus. Oh, strong work by North Melbourne allows Wayne Schwass again to get it out of the centre. Down it goes towards Hepburn. Hepburn cleverly over the top. Clarkson with a long hand pass. Arceri's got it. It's another one and North Melbourne hit the front.
Great quarter of football by North Melbourne. Completely dominated proceedings. The smaller players back in the game. Schwass has been magnificent across that centre line. He works well both in defence and in attack. Getting that ball out of the centre again. Magnificent tap on there by Hepburn to the running player Clarkson. A long one to Arceri, and magnificent play by North Melbourne, getting their teamwork going now and looking a much better side.
Mark Arceri getting his second goal there. He's had 15 possessions. If you think we've called Wayne Schwass a lot in the middle, 19 possessions. What an outstanding performance, short of half time. Love out of the middle again for North. Spargo can't mark. Lambert for the Tigers. Pops it wide for Thompson. Can't get a handle on it, but eventually does. Oh, played it well. Michael Pickering knocked off it. No whistle. Hand pass comes wide to Steele. Bauer. Caught by Stevenson. The kick wide. Comes down to the front to Lambert. Away to Mitchell. Tigers haven't had a goal for a while. Mitchell's kick. Egan underneath it. Oh, great defence by Martin to put it out in front of McCarthy, who then overran the ball. On the 50, the hand pass comes out from Young to Thompson. Back to Justin Pickering. Blocked there by Buckley. Pickering again across to Honybun. Oh, clever tap down by Knights to Honybun. But his kick off the side of the boot, no distance. Awkward one to mark.
Oh, tremendous defensive play this by North Melbourne. There's Matthew Knights going for the hand pass. Crocker tries to kick it, and North Melbourne dive in on top of it. And that was fantastic defensive play. And it's been that way for the whole quarter. And I think that Michael Martin, Bernie, typifies that North Melbourne defence.
Yes, he's come back into the game, hasn't he, Martin? He was beaten by Egan early, but he's stuck to his task.
Well, there's about 20 players around the bounce here. Lounder gets it to Trevor Poole. Poole straightens up and fires and puts it through.
And it's been a bit of a drought there for the Richmond forwards.
Well, right on the siren, Trevor Poole gets a goal for the Tigers, and he's put them back in front. But in that quarter, the Roos kick 5-8 to 2-2. Game we've had here at the MCG. Richmond by 2 points at half time after they led by 26 points at quarter time. Honeybun's been a star in the ruck. In fact, Angus is off the ground on the bench for North to start this quarter. Comes out to Mitchell. Mitchell's kicked to half forward high. Hogg pushed over. No whistle on that. Good chance here for the Tigers. Scooped up by Griffiths. In he goes to Egan, and Egan kicks the goal. Griffiths off the bench, his first touch for the game, sets up a goal.
Great start by the Tigers. Regained the lead just before the half-time break, and there's Egan who kicked the goal. Good long kick into the forward line. A couple of North Melbourne players flew for it. Not much understanding there by the North Melbourne defenders. And Stuart Griffiths, the player to regain his feet. Hand pass to Egan running through. Good play by the Tigers to set that goal up.
Terrific start this for Richmond. There's the youngster. He'll be delighted with that good piece of play. 8 points the difference after a brilliant second quarter by North Melbourne. That's Schwass, but in the meantime was a free kick to Mark Arceri. Richmond got off to a tremendous start early in this game with a three or four quick goals, but North Melbourne clawed their way back into it as they normally do. They never give up, North. Mark Arceri towards half forward. Players set themselves to loose ball. Clarkson ducks the head. Goes for the hand pass towards half forward. Crocker is there. Fairley was there also. That was Jason Love, I should say, not Fairley. It's shuffled away. Here's a chance for Clarkson again. He's brought to ground. Good umpiring to let it go. Here's Jason Love again with a quick kick. Spargo is there in front. Tony Free there for Richmond and takes it over the line.
North hit back in the second quarter with 5-8, and they hit the front just before half-time until a goal on the siren by the Tigers regained the lead. What a stack up it is in here. The umpire will ball it up. Right, a great game of football we're seeing in fine conditions. Hepburn in the ruck because Angus has been a failure. Comes away to Fairley, who kicks a goal.
Yes, that's Fairley's second goal. Good ruck work there by Hepburn, getting the tap out. And Fairley finishing it off with that goal. So North Melbourne answer that very quickly. Have a look again. Hepburn up high. There's a hand pass out to Fairley, running past and an open goal. But the Tigers didn't man up very well there at that bounce because they didn't have enough players on the defensive side.
Ian Fairley now playing out at centre-half forward and Mark Hepburn at full forward. Jamie Stevenson in the ruck. Well, that's how short they are for ruckman. Stevenson normally a key position player. Two points the difference. The Tigers in front, and this is a very entertaining game. There's Craig Lambert, who's been an excellent player today for Richmond. Out wide to the brilliant Mitchell. Very pacey player, Mitchell. He goes wide looking for Jeff Hogg. Hogg has kicked today four goals on Longmire, but to Longmire's credit, came back in the second quarter and is playing the very close and hard. It's at half forward, about 40 metres around from the Richmond goal.
Richard Lounder in his first game of VFL football. There he is, tallest man in the competition. Taller than Justin Madden. Comes out to Lambert. Back to Bauer. Off the side of the boot to the pocket. Hogg a chance. And that ball's gone out of play. And we'll have a throw in. 2 points the difference after a goal each to start the second half. Lounder and Stevenson, and over the top, McCarthy to find the boundary line.
Well, Richmond have played some brilliant halves of football this year and then been overrun in the second. That happened against Hawthorn last week and in a couple of other games. It'll be interesting to see if they can keep up the pressure. There's Lounder. Well done by Lounder as he gets it to Bauer. Bauer into the open goal has put it through.
That was brilliant play there by Lounder. Doing the ruck work in the forward pocket, playing forward pocket and doing all the ruck work when the ball comes down into the Richmond forward line. Lounder there going for the knockout, knocks it to himself and then plays on quickly with a hand pass to Bauer, setting up the goal for Richmond. And Lounder very much in the mould of John Ironmonger. I think he's already kicked more goals than John Ironmonger in his career.
I'm sure he'd be pleased you mentioned that, Bernie.
Lounder kicked two goals in the first quarter. Honybun wins in the middle. But Schwass has been an absolute star for North. Out of the centre. High to half forward. A mark! Jason Love, I think too far out to score. He'd be kicking from about 60 metres. Hepburn's down there. Oh, it's a funny old kick. Well, luck's a fortune. And the mark's taken by Clarkson. Well, he was a man out in the open, but I'm not sure he meant the pass to go there.
He was having a shot for goal, Drew.
It's another one of those where the player goes for the torpedo. And they're very hard kicks to get onto.
So, Clarkson for goal. And we're going goal for goal here in the third quarter at the MCG. Although Clarkson's missed that one.
Nine-10 plays 11-5. Not good kicking by North Melbourne. Could be costly. They're down by 7 points. We still have 20 and a half minutes of play left in the third quarter as we see the huddle at 10 and a half back, and then they branch out in all directions. The Richmond players, that is. Now you'll look for a kick out wide. That's Alan McKellar. Schwass punches the ball wide. I don't know whether Peter Wilson's 100% fit with that great big bandage on his leg. He sprints around and taps it to the boundary to the roars of delight of the Richmond supporters. But he moved reasonably well then, Wilson. Now Stevenson against Trevor Poole. Oh, the big fly over the top was by McCarthy. Spargo has been a good player. He's looking for Buckley. German is there. Oh, not Peter German's day. A touch of the fumbles and over the line it goes.
And out of bounds on the full, Peter. So it's even worse.
I don't know about that one. The boundary umpire was there, but it must have come off his knee.
Well, McKellar takes the free. German was put to the bench in the second quarter. He's had just 5 touches for the game. Thompson up towards the centre of the ground. And the mark to Lees. Might be 50. If Fairley isn't fairly careful. Lees from centre wing to half forward wide. Thompson underneath it, not required because the mark is dragged down here by Young. That's Poole, Trevor Poole. Right half forward. Umpire's going to make him come back. And kick behind the mark. Trevor Poole started the match on the bench. So far one mark. That's now his second kick. Good distance right to the goal square. Egan high. German first back there to rush it through for a behind.
Yes, intelligent play that by German. Couldn't afford to take a chance. 9-10 to 11-6. 8 points the difference now. John Longmire. Terrific duel going on between he and Jeff Hogg. Lovely kick. Because he was a full forward himself, Longmire. It's tapped away by Martin. He's been going in very, very hard today, Michael Martin. At the back is Clarkson and the flyer. Couldn't take the mark. Schwass has been brilliant. Out it comes to McCarthy. That was good play by Crocker. Up the full forward. Hepburn two bites. Couldn't take it. Mark Arceri with an open goal. Straightens up the little rover and straps and puts it through.
He's a terrific little forward pocket rover, Mark Arceri. Not much of him. But there he is kicking his third goal. You can't question his endeavour. He's in everything. There's a long kick from McCarthy into the forward line. Spills to the ground. Now Siri doing the roving. Out onto that right foot. And puts through another one for North Melbourne.
Margin back to 2 points as it was at half time. Comes to Bauer. Spins out of a tackle. His left footer wide. Griffiths, number 52. Promising start to his league career this year. Gets inside 50. Goes for goal. Great kick. Beauty.
That was sensational stuff by Griffiths. So he spent the first half on the bench. And he's come on. And kicked the goal there. But great play to break around. On a very tight angle from out on that forward flank. That's a great goal.
Well, he's been responsible for two goals. Now he handballed one to Egan. And he's kicked one himself. And John Kennedy and John Duckdale not looking too happy about that. Again, the margin is 8 points. Can North reply? Oh, there they come again. A quick kick off the ground. Spargo sets himself in front. It's fisted away to Crocker. Crocker towards half forward. Here's little Mark Arceri again. Oh, got tangled up in the boot of Spargo, and that was just bad luck. Honybun, Michael Pickering sets it up for big Lounder. The big punch comes away towards half back for North Melbourne. That's Egan to Griffiths. He's caught. Back to Egan. Brilliant skills, Egan. Onto the left foot. Up towards full forward. The high flyers are there. It's fisted away by the North defence over the line. But this is a good game of football.
Great game to watch. I mean, top endeavour from both sides. They've made a few mistakes, but you can't question either side's endeavour.
Lounder, number 37 in front. Top draft choice in 87 for the Tigers. Griffiths again. Gets knocked off it by Law. His kick smothered. Comes to Crocker. Just gets the kick out. Still trouble for North. Justin Pickering, number 2, eventually steeled with a bit of time. Kicks outside 50. Allison, what a mark.
Great mark by Brett Allison. And, well, good umpiring by Peter Cameron and Shane McDonald. They're really letting it go at the moment and making players earn their free kicks. Oh, Michael Martin dived in and copped it in the head. And umpire Shane McDonald, one of the best umpires in the VFL, right on the scene. You'll find Martin will get this kick. Michael Martin from half back up towards half forward. This is Brendan Bauer, rode beautifully. Long hand pass to Thompson, to McKellar. The lead is by Hogg. Longmire comes over the back. Beautifully done by John Law. He's got no one to kick it to. He's gone wide. Michael Pickering will be able to handball over the top to Mitchell. Or maybe the short kick. No, he's gone for the long hand pass back towards McKellar. McKellar a short one to Mitchell. Mitchell marks at half forward.
And stabs the pass up to the forward pocket. Good football. And mark taken by Poole. Tigers by 8 points. 16 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Short passes backwards. And Hogg, the full forward, gets clear.
His opponent could
couldn't run and is hobbling, will probably have to come off the ground. That's why Hogg was free, Drew.
So John Longmire in a bit of trouble. And Jeff Hogg, who kicked three goals in the first quarter, now going for number five. Be a handy break to the Tigers if he can kick this. Never in doubt.
There's Peter Lundmeyer's in a lot of trouble. The trainer's out there attending him now, but Hogg, that's five goals straight to Jeff Hogg. Top performance by him at full forward. And also good thinking to make that lead when he knew that Longmire was in trouble. So North Melbourne could be in strife if Longmire can't take his place at fullback. The side would be very depleted if they have Longmire off the ground.
Well, back to the centre. 14 points the difference, and Longmire's still hobbling down there. I wonder if they haven't got enough fit men to come on. There's Buckley to Schwass. He's lost it to Lambert. Lambert swings onto the left foot. The Tigers looking good. Out wide to the Pacey Mitchell. Not many people have beat him for the ball. Oh, well done by Steele to block that run to the left. But Mitchell's able to get back and hook it towards half forward. Martin is there, was caught. Over to Ellison. Now, the loose ball is by Matthew Knights. He got that one high. Umpire paying advantage. It comes to Stuart Griffiths again. A long kick to Lounder. No mark. Kick by Lounder. It just trickles away. Good effort by John Law. As it trickles over the line, 13-7-85, Richmond North, 10-10-70, and Warwick Inglis about to come on, and there he is. That's his rotten luck for North Melbourne.
Well, it could be in a bit of strife here, North. They've already come into this game without the likes of Jimmy Cracker, Matthew Larkin. Stevens' kick up towards centre wing. Love puts the hand pass away into no man's land. Bad bounce there for Allison. Comes back Richmond's way. Here goes Peter Wilson on a gallop. Takes it right up to the 50. Oh, he might kick it himself. Nobody came towards him. What a goal by Wilson!
And the Tigers on a roll at the moment. Great play by Wilson. There's Longmire in a lot of trouble, but Wilson, very exuberant type player, can sometimes run himself into trouble. Has a few bounces too many on occasions. And running there right into the forward line. Ran into within 40 metres. Kicked the goal. Great play, Peter Wilson.
Michael Roberts on the boundary. Michael?
John Longmire twisted his ankle on the soft turf down in the forward pocket and looks in a lot of pain. His left ankle.
Well, this will test North out. 21 points. And that's a free kick, I think, to Richmond. Holding the man with no 50. Umpire Shane McDonald realising that the North Melbourne player didn't realise it was a free kick. We'll come back to Brendan Bauer and the Tigers. Well, there's a shot of the ankle, John Longmire, and probably doubtful whether he'll come back. Oh, Mitchell! We've seen some brilliant high marking here at the MCG today, and that's one of numerous high marks. Honybun took a couple, Egan took a couple. Now Michael Mitchell, and looks like it's a loose man on in Jeff Hogg. Yes. And they're going to miss Longmire down there. That's Jamie Stevenson trying to put the pressure on, but Hogg has kicked five, going for number six.
Yeah, Stevenson now playing at full back. Was playing in the ruck at the start of this quarter. And Angus is now playing back in the ruck.
Well, Jeff Hogg, I'm sure if Richmond had a good year and kicked plenty of high scores, he is quite capable of kicking 100 goals, this man, because he's a great kick and he leads well. Hogg from directly in front for goal number six. Nice straight boot, straight through the ball for a goal.
Six goals to Jeff Hogg. And the Tigers running away with it a little bit in this third quarter. Big lead to Richmond. They've completely dominated this quarter. I think North Melbourne, with the injuries that they've had, have had to throw their side around. There's a kick from Hogg. As I said, six goals straight. A great exhibition of goal kicking.
Michael Roberts on the boundary line. Michael.
Yes, I've just been talking to the North Melbourne doctor and he said he may have broken a bone in his left ankle. John Longmire.
Oh, that's terrible news for North. 27-point lead now to the Tigers, who in this quarter have kicked 6-2 to 2 goals 1. Bauer out of the middle. Long and high. Hogg a chance again against Stevenson. Knocked forward by McKenna. Oh, goal coming up here. Trevor Poole runs onto it and missed it.
Should have been a certain goal, that one. Poole just wouldn't sit up for him properly. He wouldn't bounce right. But he hurried that kick. Had a little bit more time to steady and just have a little bit more of a look.
John Law, 28 points of difference. North in trouble. Schwass. Over the back was Angus. Well, it's tapped back towards Honybun. A quick kick. Stuart Griffiths. Oh, good mark. What a good mark. And he's gone short. Intelligent play to Trevor Poole. That's a mark. Caught in no man's land was McCarthy and John Kennedy. Not very happy at all.
Well, he's got plenty of worries, John Kennedy. Looks Richmond. It's been a great performance by Richmond.
He looks a good player, that young Griffiths, Bernie.
He does. Very good prospect.
Well, Trevor Poole missed certainly a moment ago. He's kicked one directly in front. He stabs. It's another one.
So that's Poole's second goal. One in the second quarter, now one in this third quarter. Started off on the bench with Andy Goodwin at centre-half forward, but Goodwin was having a very bad day at centre-half forward. Poole's now playing there and has given the Tigers a lift on the forward line. There's the mark. McCarthy caught in no man's land. And the kick from Poole from only about 30 metres out. So the Tigers on a roll.
And young Stuart Griffiths, who set that up again, playing just his fourth game of league football, 20 years of age from Old Melburnians, and looks a player of the future. Honybun has absolutely dominated the ruck against little opposition. This is chopped off by Allison, up to centre half forward. Oh, clever and courageous. Ooh. Mark. It crashed into a wall down there, Spargo, but held onto the mark. Now, early in the quarter, it was goal for goal, and since then, Richmond have gone away to kick five in a row. Boy, did North need this. Although, man on the mark's about 51 metres out. Probably too far for Spargo. 10 metres short. Oh, it comes to the back, a chance for Love. Rush through for a behind.
And the Richmond crowd making plenty of noise, and Jason Love's limping around a bit now, but if they can kick two or three quick ones North, they wouldn't be out of it. They've got to be only a couple behind at three-quarter time. Brian Lees has gone wide to Michael Pickering, who's very strong overhead. He's taken, 11 marks for the game. Well, that's not a bad effort at centre wing. As we see, this is Trevor Poole's added a lot of life to that forward line as he brings it towards the half forward line. Michael Martin was grabbed very high then. Umpire Cameron missed that one. It's taken away by Egan. Sprints at goal and has missed, but Martin was grabbed right around the neck as he charged in after that ball.
They're too pacey for them at the moment, Richmond. Oh, Schwass has gone out of the game in this third quarter after being best on the ground in that first half. But this young Richmond side, full of running.
Kick in by Stevenson. Martin takes the mark at half-back flank. Up to centre wing. Oh, Michael Pickering. Same direction as the ball. Too much skill for every player in that pack. Short pass is good to Knights. True centre wing position. Young Matthew Knights goes long with his kick. Mitchell. One hand. McRae. Bouncing out of defence. Switching direction. Two against two here. Love, good mark.
Jason Love, they really want a couple of quick goals. North, oh, that's kicked to a man who's under pressure, but it's a good move. I think they've moved McCarthy to the forward line. They have to do something. McCarthy, right deep. Oh, two North Melbourne players charged into each other. That's bad play. Knights has lost the ball. Could have been holding it as the umpire will come in and bounce it. And there's another. Oh, he's hurt. Oh, it might be cramp. Let's see. Is that Brett Ellison down there? Yep. No, it might be just cramp, I think. 71 plays 105, and North badly need a couple of goals with 9.5 minutes left in this third quarter. Angus, oh, they're getting thrashed in the ruck. Oh, there's Crocker, couldn't grab it. And they're too good and too quick at the moment. Trevor Poole, that's Richmond. Out wide it goes from Lambert. Stuart Griffiths looks a good player. This time he's caught. Hand pass comes away to Crocker. And the umpire said he was held after he handballed that Stuart Griffiths, so it'll be his free kick in the forward pocket.
And already seven possessions. Out wide to Mitchell in the pocket. He's got it just inside the line. Very awkward angle to goal.
The way they're going, he'd probably kick this, Drew.
Well, Michael Mitchell has 22 possessions. And this is great for football. Richmond desperately needed this win. They came in with one win out of three games. Mitchell for goal. Across the face. Lounder with the height. And it goes out of bounds on the full. They needed the win. I'm not saying that they've got it by any stretch of the imagination yet, but they do lead by 34 points.
Well, they're in a great position. Oh, Egan went for the big fly. He's taken a couple of those today. There's Matthew Knights. Quick hand pass. Comes back to Pickering. That's Michael Pickering. Gives it across to his brother, Justin. There's Big Lounder in the centre of the pack. Darren Steele, a quick kick out. Michael Pickering sets himself. He's bumped off the ball. That was clever play by Ellison. Pickering, though, comes back. Gives it to Tony Free. Free sets it up for the high flyers. Lounder in the middle of the pack. It's a loose ball. Brilliant play by Poole. Goes in after it. Nearly got away with it. Kicked off the ground. In the meantime, umpire Peter Cameron says it's my ball and he'll bounce it.
North Melbourne went into this game as favourites. But they drifted in the market at quarter time when the Tigers led by 26 points. But when North had got back to within 2 points at half time, I think in most people's eyes, most people thought North would go away in the second half. Richmond have faded in second halves before, but it's been a brilliant third quarter here by the Tigers. Knights pulled off. It comes to Griffiths. Oh, it's another one.
Great quarter of football. Two goals to Griffiths. And it's been the young Tigers, the smaller players in this Richmond side. Too much pace for North Melbourne.
And we believe that's his mother in the crowd. If it is his mother, well, she's more than happy. If she's just a Tigers supporter, well, she's got reason to be happy with a new star on the scene.
Bernie Quinlan thinks a very young mother, in fact.
Well, he's just 20 years of age.
Well, that's right. He's a good little player. 71 plays 111 as the big punch away comes from the centre. Mitchell is the flyer. Oh, gee, they look quick and look pretty good. That was Trevor Poole being legged. There's Michael Pickering and Lambert crashes his way in. Gee, they're going in hard. Well, Richmond, Michael Thompson out wide. Beautiful play to Bauer. He's a good kick on the left foot too, Brendan Bauer. This should be a mark, and it is, to Jamie Stevenson. Hogg's kick six. Not on Stevenson, of course. He's kicked one on him. Now Hogg. Over the back of the pack. Chance now for North Melbourne. Jason Lovelay. Looks slow, North Melbourne, compared with Richmond. The kick bounces over the line.
Well, we've said it so many times. Don't underestimate a team coached by John Kennedy. But one wonders now whether he has the ammunition out there to do the job. Because they came in short of a few and they've lost a few with injuries today. Free did well to keep that ball in. Mitchell at the back. He knocked it nearly up into the cricketer's dressing room.
I'm sure now there's the boot of who? John Longmire. So maybe we will see him back on the ground after all. We've had the magic spray. But I'm sure that Kevin Bartlett would have stressed their fade outs. Richmond at half time, but they haven't faded out this time. There's Matthew Knights looking for Hogg towards the pocket. Hogg appealing for the free kick, puts it off the ground and puts it out of bounds. Oh, it had to hit the post, so that's out of bounds on the full.
Well, I'll have to put that down as his first miss, which is a bit unfortunate. He hacked that out of the air. He kicked six straight before that. Stevenson, what a task. Had a bit of a go in the ruck. Now he's on a full forward who's hot. No mark, wasn't first touch, was it? Umpire said play on. Now it'll be a ball up. Honeybun's been superb in the ruck. He's taken some screamer marks. He's taken six marks and had 14 possessions, which is a big day's work. close to the boundary line. Law took a long time to turn around and make a U-turn. The ball goes out of play.
I really do feel you don't like to make excuses for injuries, but in full marks to the Tigers, there's Longmire warming up around the boundary line, but gee, they missed Larkin and Jimmy Cracker. That's a free kick to North Melbourne, as you can see. They really have missed their zip around the packs. Have been thrashed at the centre bounces, Bernie.
Yeah, 24 hitouts to Honeybun.
And Richmond have got it out most of the time. This is Hepburn. Long driving kick towards centre wing. He's had a pretty quiet day. And Honeybun, again, ducking back to take the mark over to McKellar. McKellar wide, Brendan Bauer. And gee, they're playing with confidence. And look at this, a loose man there in Michael Thompson, a backman. He runs to half forward. He's going to kick a long one, a long floater. Oh, this will be a mark to Hogg. Yes! With his name written all over that. And they're missing Longmire down there. Hogg's kick six, Bernie.
Yes, including two in this quarter. Well, there's a kick from Thompson. Long and direct, caught the North Melbourne defenders out of position. And Stevenson was a good 10 metres away.
Well, all full forwards like to kick double figures. He's kicked six. If he kicks this, it'll be seven with a quarter to go and 4 minutes. So, he might be a chance today, Jeff Hogg, to kick double figures. Look at him sneaking out. That's intelligent play. He kicks and has missed, so he won't be happy with that.
...57 goals last year. Hogg, who seems to have taken over from Michael Roach in the full forward post for the Tigers, although Roach kicked a few today in the reserves. Stevenson kicks in, looking for Hepburn. Came from behind, gets it down to Crocker. Just gets the hand pass away. Angus fumbles. They fumble further at ground level. German's had an absolute shocker. Free. That's a good mark to Steele. Darren Steele. Short pass to Arceri at centre half-back. Well, North were running earlier in this quarter, and certainly in the second quarter. Off to Buckley, puts it wide here to Spargo. It's an open forward line. German goes past looking for the hand pass. Spargo centres, good pass. And there's a mark to Martin, a defender turned forward. And Michael Martin will be lining up for goals. Four goals this year, total of 25 in his league career, but we don't often see him down this end. North need this. Boy, is that an understatement. 41 points down. Missed.
Well, he kicked that like a backman, Drew. Amazing the number of times backmen go down forward, they can't kick goals.
Although he played a lot of his junior football, under-19 football, as a forward.
That's quite true, as we see Lees towards Honeybun. Oh, the loose ball is with Michael Thompson. He's trying to draw the man. Oh, Clive Allison didn't want to run at him. It comes over the top to Egan. Egan sets it up for the half forwards. Oh, Hogg coming right up the ground. Stevenson caught. It's in the hand pass to Steele. Steele to Crocker. Love. Long hand pass to Schwass. Wayne Schwass. Oh, he went for the hand pass over the top. Still goes in after. Good play by Wayne Schwass. He needs a bit of support down there. Pushed in the back. Well, I thought it was in the back, Bernie.
I agree with you, Peter.
Well, I thought sure it was dead set in the middle of the back, but umpire Peter Cameron.
Here it is again.
So. Yes, oh, look at yes. That. How could he miss that, honestly?
Right in front of him.
Neither ruckman could get that. Lambert has had nearly 20 hand passes. Out to Egan, he pops one off to Bauer. And Bauer goes for a gallop down the wing. Shepherding by Thompson, and Thompson is rewarded, gets it. Back to Bauer. Oh, you're gone, he tried too much, holding the ball. It's amazing how little blokes in league football are usually the best tacklers. Arceri that time.
Yes, that's quite true. And well, they're playing with so much confidence, Richmond. They're preparing to take risks. And that's what caused that problem there. McCarthy couldn't take it. He crashes his way in. Well done, Peter Wilson. Should lay off the hand pass. Left it a little bit late. Arceri, a quick kick. He punched away from Hepburn. Crocker's had a touch of the fumbles today. Oh, he's lost his trousers. Almost. Well done by Egan. As he got it to Justin Pickering. Now it's Wilson. Beautiful play, Wilson. And it's a pity more sides don't get their forwards to work around a player who leads like Hogg. And I think Carlton could do that, take a leaf out of the book of Richmond.
Yes, well, they've got a good player to kick to, but their tackling and chasing and harassing has been outstanding today.
Jeff Hogg has kicked six, going for goal number seven from 45 metres. What a beautiful kicking style that is. Straight through the middle.
It's been a great performance by Hogg, seven goals. But his job has been made easy by the play further up the field. The Tigers defenders, the smaller players, they delivered the ball well. There's Wilson with plenty of time to steady. And really, the fullback's job is very hard when the ball is delivered in such a fashion.
Well, just 15 seconds left in the quarter. In this term, Richmond have kicked 9 goals, 5 to 2, 3. And earlier in the year against Footscray, in one quarter, the Tigers kicked 11. So we perhaps should have learnt something from that. Here's Lambert for his 20th hand pass today. To Bauer, back to Egan, ducks the high tackle, Schwass gets him. Lambert, rather Egan, gets another chance. The hand pass is intercepted, off by Hepburn. North out of time, just as they were going forward. What a quarter by the Tigers. They're 18-10, 118, leading North 10-12, 72.
Start of the final quarter here at the MCG after a brilliant third quarter. Scores very even at half-time. But Richmond, a magnificent third quarter, belted away from North Melbourne. There, Schwass was a bit quieter in the third quarter after a brilliant first half. Wilson kicked the top goal during that third quarter. This is Mark Arceri, who has battled his heart out today for North Melbourne, but they've been undermanned. Oh, there's a big mark over the top of the pack. That's McCarthy. McCarthy started off at centre-half back and was a pretty good player.
There's a centering kick from Arceri. And McCarthy now on the forward line, top grab.
Well, he hasn't kicked a goal as yet. He's had 12 kicks himself and he puts this one straight through the centre. Maybe this will be the start of a revival.
Still a long way to go though for North Melbourne. Just the start they needed. But they haven't looked good enough. They've lost the ball out of the centre square on most occasions. He won it on that occasion through Schwass again, who went out of the game in that third quarter. Arceri screwing the ball back into the centre, centering kick. Great mark for McCarthy. But they need more out of the centre.
Schwass, 20 possessions in the first half, but just 5 in the third quarter. Points the difference. Honybun couldn't get it clear of the ruck. German, one of his few kicks today. Schwass charging after this again. Oh, it spills back here. Picked up by Clarkson. Dodges and weaves. A second and a minute would be handy. But he's offline with that kick and out of bounds on the full.
Yes, Alistair. Clarkson probably should have set that up to the forwards then. Tried to centre it instead of blazing away. But still, they need goals and they need them quickly. It's a free kick going Richmond's way to Michael Pickering. For in the back, umpires today, Peter Cameron and Shane McDonald. Shane McDonald deliberating on that one. Pickering again, he's very good in the air. He's taken 9 marks, 13 kicks he's had. Gone wide. Honybun has taken a couple of outstanding marks today. High marks right over packs. Up it goes towards centre wing. John Law tries to punch it away. This man played a magnificent third quarter. Young Stuart Griffiths, where he kicked 2 goals. Now it's Knights. Lovely foot pass to Jeff Hogg. Hogg's already kicked 7 and a big chance today to kick double figures.
And another fullback also. Martin now playing fullback. Good leading by Hogg in front of Martin. And great delivery of the ball.
Well, no doubt in my mind, this man could kick 100 if Richmond have a reasonably good year. He's a beautiful looking kick. Lovely drop punt. And it is only 1 point, but it was very, very close.
North Melbourne need a real avalanche here in this last quarter if they're to get up and win. We saw them do it against Geelong here. Get up and beat them by 2 points. Big kick in. There's Honybun. Another one. That's his 10th mark. Having one of his best days. David Honybun, 60 metre drop punt. Lounder, almost. Oh, he dodges through like a rover. Comes to Griffiths, ducks. Off the ground, it's a goal. That's a free kick back here to Griffiths.
Oh, what a dream debut, Bernie.
Been tremendous, hasn't he, Griffiths? And good stuff too by Lounder, the big bloke. Nearly took the mark, but battled on well when the ball hit the ground.
Not quite his debut, this is his fourth game, but he did come on having spent the first half on the bench.
My apologies, I thought it was his first.
This is for goal number three for young Stuart Griffiths.
Yes, he's been very good, Griffiths. As have most of the Richmond players. And a top performance by the Tigers. Lander's been impressive in that forward pocket. There he is, nearly taking the mark. Battles on well. Big Richard Lounder. And there's a free kick. Much too high on Griffiths. Only a small player. What is he? 177 centimetres.
Actually, Hogg kicked that goal. So, interesting that the umpire made it come back to Griffiths.
Extremely difficult task this for North Melbourne. They really lack big man strength. North Melbourne has been, they've been found out today where Honybun has dominated the centre. As Drew said a moment ago, he's taken 10 marks. He got nearly every hit out. And as a consequence, Richmond have benefited from that by getting the ball out of the centre. There it is again, put onto the chest of Mitchell. Mitchell brilliantly to Justin Pickering, to Lambert, back to Egan. What magnificent football. Egan into the open goal. Well, champagne football by the Tigers.
Philip Egan's second goal after a great passage of play by the Tigers. Once again starting in the centre with David Honybun. Here's Mitchell, long hand pass. Another hand pass over to Lambert. And there's Egan streaming through, having a shot from about 30 metres out, but a great passage of play by the Tigers.
Well, Craig Lambert gave the last hand pass. He did bring his boots today, but he hasn't used them too often. 8 kicks, 21 hand passes. Well, Richmond really confounding the critics here and turning on a sensational display. North out of the centre. Fairley, kick and hope. Laffey can't mark. Arceri, Rovers goal. But he missed that. And out of bounds on the fourth. Mark Arceri's first miss. He kicked three straight before that.
Peter Wilson on screen with the heavily strapped right thigh. He's had 12 kicks and 6 handballs. A brilliant goal he kicked in the third quarter. He loves to run and bounce. And it really set the crowd alight. That short pass has found McKellar. The Tigers have been looking like winning a good game. They've had some brilliant halves and then fallen down towards the end of games. But they've put it together today. Mitchell tries to get in the hand pass, grabbed by Darren Steele. The short one is on, and he has found Spargo. Spargo over the top, it was smothered off the hands. This is Matthew Knights, only a youngster. Beautiful skills. Over to Michael Thompson. Justin Pickering coming down centre wing. They're playing with confidence, the Tigers. Pickering's brought down from behind. Oh, the bounce is even favouring them now.
Michael Mitchell gets free, gets to the 50. Centering kick is beautiful onto the chest of Poole. Well, Trevor Poole, who spent the first half of the game on the bench, has come on to kick 2 goals, 1 so far. And look at the work of Mitchell there. And he's had 26 possessions, Mitchell. Poole for his third goal. No movement from the goal umpire.
Three goals to Poole, and he's lifted the Tigers at centre-half forward. Been a good player, former Victorian representative. And here's the bounce, nothing going right for North Melbourne. Bounces over Steele's head. Mitchell, who's been a top player for the Tigers, onto that left foot to the leading Poole. And Poole kicking his third.
Even though he got the bounce, Mitchell, he still did that brilliantly. 78 plays 137. North normally fight games right out, but the way they're going today, Richmond, I don't know whether they can. Whether they can come back. Well, I certainly doubt whether they can win it, but whether they can fight their way back and kick a few goals, because Richmond are playing with enormous confidence. Look at the players round the ball. Had some top players today. Honybun at the centre bounces. That's Matthew Knight's. Oh, clever little kick to Brendan Bauer. Bauer with a hand pass. He's looking for Justin Pickering. He hooks it back towards Big Lounder. Lounder comes out. Is it on mark? I think there was touched in between there. Well, the mark's been played. He took about four or five bites. I felt one North Melbourne player might have got one touch to it, but still a big grin on the face of Richard Lounder.
Yeah, I think it did too, Peter. One, two. There was touched there by Martin.
Came off his head too.
Yes, it was. I don't think that was a mark.
Well, the umpire would have found that very difficult to see, but still Lounder's got the free kick from directly in front. Big Richard Lounder, he's already kicked two. He's normally a pretty good kick. Look at that. Taut instep, bang, right through the middle.
Three goals for Richard Lounder. Hasn't had a run on the ball. He's done all the ruck work in the forward pocket. It's been a good display by Lounder. Taking a lot of pressure off Richmond. The big man up in that forward line. Have a look at that again. It bounced off Michael Martin's head there, and it shouldn't have been a mark, but the umpire probably couldn't see it from where he was.
Well, it's been a luxury that big Richard Lounder at 203 centimetres can just prop in the forward pocket. So well as Honybun gone. This time Hepburn wins out of the middle. Fairley, a further kick to half forward. McKellar a spoil. It comes to German. He pops the hand pass to McCarthy, and the former centre-half back kicks again for his second.
And that just shows the difference of moving the ball out of the centre. Winning the centre bounce there was Hepburn. Quickly into the forward line, and that's just something that North Melbourne haven't been able to do today. They've been beaten badly in the ruck. Honybun has turned in a top performance. Angus was completely overpowered by him. There's McCarthy now playing at centre-half forward, kicking the goal. But they've had to make a lot of changes, North Melbourne.
Yes, and their lack of big men showing. And really also lack of key forwards. But full master, Richmond. They've been promising this for ages, as we see Buckley towards half forward. Umpire calling play on. Jason Love taps it away, but Tony Free, they're coming home hard. Richmond, they're not satisfied. Oh, he's off. The big man was off. That was Angus. Really silly play, really, because he ran straight to the three Tigers. The loose ball comes to Justin Pickering. Oh, cleverly to Egan. Now, where's Hogg? Hogg waits at the back. Big Lounder's there also. Nearly a mark to Stevenson. A loose ball to Griffiths. He goes in after it. Oh, it's Griffiths now with the ball as he hooks it back on the left. And little Stuart Griffiths has put through another one.
There's two goals in the third quarter and now two goals in the last. And Richmond have killed North Melbourne at ground level. The smaller players have been brilliant. North Melbourne looking very much a beaten side from about halfway through that third quarter. And Griffiths doing the work, the roving work in that forward pocket, finishing it off.
Trevor Poole was the man that gave out that hand pass to Griffiths.
Angus in the ruck against Honybun. Honybun wins another one. It comes through the pack. Oh, this is too easy. Away goes Poole. Steers the ball. Well, it's more than a steer. He's roosted it. And a mark to Lounder. Well, the floodgates have opened. And you don't want to be facing this tidal wave.
There's a long kick by Poole. Good play. Again, coming from the hit out from Honybun. Lounder's had three kicks for three goals.
And now four.
So four kicks for four goals to Richard Lounder. And the Tigers continue on their merry way. It's been a great performance by Richmond. Honybun in the ruck particularly. Getting the ball out to Poole. A good knockout. And Lounder just too big and too strong in that goal square, taking a very strong mark.
Well, not many sides can give North Melbourne a hiding like this. Good performance by the Tigers. Angus that time got the ball down. Brett Allison is there. Angus are in after it again. He's only a youngster. You'll learn a lot by this game. Kicked towards half forward by Steele, grabbed by Laffey, and what confidence they're playing with. Matthew Knights, the big fly over the top. What a great mark.
Well, they can do no wrong, the Tigers. What a mark by Knights. Lambert kicks for a change. What a pass. But Hogg couldn't take the mark. Comes here to Martin, who bounces away from Hogg. Martin's kick over the centre. McCarthy couldn't take it. Michael Pickering breaks a tackle. Puts it out to Knights. Must be dizzy after that mark. Martin outmarks Hogg.
Well, Michael Martin has battled his heart out today under extreme odds. He's had 10 kicks. But, well, he's tried very, very hard. He's probably in his rightful position now at fullback. There's Brendan Bauer. He's going short to McKellar. He's got loose men everywhere there. Short ball is on again. Stuart Griffiths. What a dream game he's having since coming off the bench. He's going for another kick at goal for his fifth. Oh! Touched right on the line. Well, he's not a bad little rover.
Oh, fantastic. So Richmond have kicked 6-2 in this quarter to North 2 goals, and they've run away with this game in the second half after leading by just 2 points at half time. Kick straight up the center. Angus is there, sandwiched out of it. Fierce tackling by the Tigers. That one's in the back, says the umpire. And Mark Arceri last up to take the free kick. Comes out to the wing. Well, it's 2-1 Richmond. Easy mark to Egan. And probably another goal coming up here. Egan runs away. Kicks long. Lounder with all the height. And Stevenson just with a hand to it to rush it through from behind.
Well, there's Philip Egan. It was a good lead there made by Jeff Hogg. Maybe could have had that option. He elected to kick long. 24-13 to 12-12. I don't think Richmond, well, Carlton have to meet up to Richmond next week. I don't think that's going to be an easy game for Carlton. As on the form today, there's Honybun and Richmond full march to them there. The policy of playing youth. There's Angus. Up in the air it goes. Waiting underneath it is Alan McKellar. That mop of shaggy hair. He's from centre wing. He brings it towards the pocket. Hogg waits at the back. But oh, what a good mark. Michael Pickering. It'll have to be paid. Umpire Shane McDonald on the scene. Pickering very strong overhead, Bernie.
Yes, he's taken a lot of marks today, Pickering.
Ten
marks. That's a great performance, both on the back line and on the forward line. Let's have a look at that one again. Coming across in front of the pack, going with the flight of the ball.
Michael Pickering, coming off as Lambert, has been an excellent player, particularly with his handball. And there's the kick by Michael Pickering. The goal umpire says 1 point. We gathered that by the crowd at the back. Hardly a murmur. Coming back on, another youngster showed a little bit of form early before being rested, Barry Young.
Lambert's possessions worth recounting. 9 kicks, 21 handballs before he went to the bench. Oh, what a mark by Schwass. Quickly off with a hand pass to Buckley. Schwass been quieter in the second half though. Buckley's kick down towards the forward pocket. McCarthy underneath the ball and taken away by Lees. Ball out of play for a boundary throw-in. 24-13 Richmond. Brian Lees. I think he got away with murder then. He went deliberately for the line.
I think he looks a pretty happy man. All those defenders do. They love it when it's not coming down. I don't care if they don't get a kick as long as it's going there in. There's Honeybun, who's just controlled that ruck work. Mark Arceri has battled hard onto the left foot. He goes. He's even taking one-handed marks and doing little flicks of the ball there, Brian Lees. He's brought it wide around the boundary line and it beats Justin Pickering over the line, and he's not happy about it.
Well, Richmond went into this game just 4 from the bottom with a percentage of 87. This will be a percentage booster. And in a tight competition, percentage is going to be pretty important. Kick up towards centre wing. Clarkson, hand pass underground. Schwass pulled off the ball. Oh, Richmond get it out. Cleverly flipped on by Justin Pickering. Steele loses it. Look at the tackling of Richmond. Comes to Egan. Mitchell.
Oh!
You can't do that, son. Oh!
He couldn't look disgusted about that decision.
What a little ribbon that one was.
It was a backdoor flip.
The shades of the old Teddy Whitten flick pass, only worse. Over the back is McCarthy, cop one high. Throws it away also. There's Brendan Bauer, who's played well, particularly in the second half. A quick kick, Crocker. Been a pretty quiet player, Darren Crocker. Now, he brings it towards half forward. A chance for the pack to fly. Oh, there's been some big leaps today. This is Barry Young. Oh, long hand pass is good play to Matthew Knights. Knights to McKellar. McKellar to Justin Pickering. Was brought down from behind, and Peter Cameron set a trip.
And he's reporting him too.
What a deliberate trip. Well, someone got fined for that earlier in the year, didn't they?
Well, it is a reportable offence. Let's have a look at it again.
Let's have a look.
Yes, it's definitely a trip.
Well, it was a trip and it's in the book. Oh! Hip and shoulder that by Steele, but he ran straight at Trevor Poole and collected him when Michael Mitchell was about to take the mark. Trevor Poole has livened up that side since he came on the ground, Bernie.
Yes, well, they got nothing out of the centre-half forward position in that first half.
Well, he's kicked three goals. He's normally a good kick. He's kicked it high and straight, and it's a goal.
Been a very good player. That's two goals in the last quarter, four goals in total. John Kennedy looking disgusted with the performance. But when you consider they've had a few players injured, Longmire off the ground, there's Poole kicking that goal, his fourth, and then the Tigers 25th. They've ran right away with this match. Very impressive performance by Richmond.
Not a bad side.
Kevin Bartlett, and the Tigers about to get their second win of the season. Honybun wins another one in the middle, but this one comes to Arceri. Poor old kick. Comes to McKellar. Out to the wing. Steele covered ground to get there and make it a contest. Egan sprints after it. Bad bounce. Schwass gets to the front. Is legged. And Schwass will take the free kick. We talk about avenues to goal. Hogg's kicked seven for the Tigers, and three players have kicked four. Poole, Lounder and Griffiths. The coach would have to be happy with that. The umpire's going to make Schwass come back and kick over the man on the mark. 27 possessions, but he had about 20 of them to half time. Hand pass out by Arceri to Love, and a late goal to North.
Well, they just had too little up on their forward line today, North Melbourne. They've struggled to get the ball out of the centre. That's Love's first goal. And Fairley's been very quiet as well. Only kicking two goals after kicking six last week. But it's how you get that ball out of the middle that matters. And they just haven't been able to do that.
Well, they've got a number of medium-sized players, North Melbourne. Not enough big men. But still, they win a lot of games through their sheer determination and effort. Oh! Really caught with the ball with Buckley. It was John Law with a quick kick. Towards half forward, it's tapped away. This is McCarthy. Pretty good player, McCarthy. An open goal, a long kick. And he has threaded it through for another one.
McCarthy's kicked three goals now, all in this last quarter. But too little, too late for North Melbourne. There he is, McCarthy going for the mark. Good recovery. Backs up, follows up, and a good long kick for goal. But North Melbourne, just not enough of that this afternoon.
Well, North probably need him at centre-half back, but he is a beautiful kick, and surely that McCarthy would make an excellent forward. Well, a couple of late goals here to North Melbourne, but Richmond, 25 goals. And when you consider they were just nine goals at half-time. North out of the middle again. Almost a throw. Comes to free. Steele camped under this to take the mark. Pops off the hand pass. Taken by Law when I don't think it was meant for him. And he's run into trouble. The hand pass to Arceri. Pops it over the top to Buckley. Buckley finds a man in space, German, who's had a poor day. That's a pass that goes past McCarthy. Love. Hasn't made the distance. Fairley's had a quiet day. Lees knocks it to the boundary line and we'll have a throw in.
Good defensive play by Brian Lees there. But they haven't had many good forwards. When Schwass has kicked three, McCarthy three, is after going down there, Mark Arceri three. Relying on those smaller type players. That's Ben Buckley heading towards the line and puts it over. We have 9 minutes exactly left in this final quarter. And what an impressive display by the young Tigers. Honeybun's been magnificent in the ruck. Mark Arceri, a quick kick, hooks it back towards the goals. Laffey cleverly out wide to Justin Pickering. Pickering brings it towards the half back line. There's only one man there, and that's John Law. Law to Spargo. Spargo again sets up another one for North and puts it right through.
Spargo's another one of the North Melbourne players that has been hobbling a little bit. He appears to have some sort of a leg injury. But Richmond bringing their defence didn't take it wide enough. Took it too straight up the ground in the corridor, allowed North Melbourne to take possession and have a straight shot at goal.
Well, North Melbourne have kicked the last three goals, and that'll be something that Kevin Bartlett won't be happy with. We've had 40 goals kicked today in Melbourne's fine conditions. Angus beats Honeybun. Well, he's knocked off it by Lees, who comes out with the ball. It's a bit of a wrestle. And holding the ball, says the umpire, you've got to make some attempt to get the hand pass away. Free kick quickly taken by Buckley. North getting some easy goals late in the game. This comes to Schwass. Beats a tackle. Goes for goal from 40 metres. Offline, out of bounds.
Couldn't move then, Spargo, Bernie.
No, he was limping in that first half.
Well, maybe they have a number of injuries, but that's certainly taking nothing away from the brilliant performance of Richmond today. It's been a delight to watch. Spargo would normally have taken that mark. I think there's McKellar to Egan. Smothered off the boot. Good use of the body there by Bauer. Grabbed by Jason Love. Love a quick hand pass. Schwass. Now, was that in the back? Umpire paid the advantage there. The quick kick at the goals. And it's through to North. Good goal.
Yeah, so North Melbourne adding a little bit of respectability. Fairly kicking that goal. And that's his third, but... A quiet day for Philly. There's Love getting the pass out. Free kick would have been paid to Schwass. He was shoved fair and square in the back, but Fairley cleaning up, kicking that goal on the left foot. Quiet afternoon for Fairley. Three goals.
Well, North have kicked the last four goals. Richmond have kicked 7-6 in this last quarter. Tigers out of the middle again through Knights. Up to centre half forward. Off hands, Griffiths for number five. Hand pass to Lounder, knocked off it by Stevenson, who finds Steele. And North getting some sort of running game going when it's all over. Clarkson, fairly at half forward, behind. Lees almost. McCarthy a clever tap out, but gathered by Michael Pickering. In the gathering gloom here at the MCG, it's pretty dark. Well, McKellar breaks a tackle. Beautiful pass. And here's young Griffiths again.
Oh, geez, played well. Egan's been a good player too. A long kick coming up towards the forward line. Martin, caught, handballs away. Here's a chance for Richmond again. This is the youngster having a shot, and very young. And he's put it through.
Yeah, they just eased up a little bit, Richmond, in this last quarter, allowing North Melbourne to kick a few goals. But Martin there dropping a mark that he should have taken. Out in front of Hogg, dropped a sitter and nearly holding the ball as well. That's where Richmond have won it all afternoon at ground level. And Young, the player, cleaning up, kicking his first.
And Barry Young is a youngster, just 18 years of age. The youngest cub in a very young Richmond outfit. Playing his second game of league football and getting his first goal here today. Honeybun again, German. To half forward, McCarthy. First touch, we'll get a free kick. Elgin not in possession. Advantage paid. Sweeping hand pass up the ground. Spargo from 15 metres has missed.
Very casual, but then again, he might be carrying that injury.
He's kicked two goals, but he's missed another four. So two goals, four. He's had the chances, but there he is. You can see he's limping, Spargo.
Well, Richmond are exactly 10 goals in front at 60 points. Justin Pickering, all those medium-sized players have played well for Richmond. They've been a real team effort. There's Peter German with a quick kick to half forward, but the mark has been taken by Michael Laffey. Laffey, as it gets very, very dark here at the MCG. The high flyer there was McCarthy. Taken away by German to Crocker. Darren Crocker's gone short and he finds Angus. Angus to Law. Law kicking long, hoping someone can take a mark at the back is Fairley. He couldn't take it. There's Alistair Clarkson on the left foot, hooking it back. Mark Arceri marks into the open goal and he puts it through for his fourth.
Well, they've lifted a little bit in this last quarter, North Melbourne, but really it's far too late. Three-quarter time, that third, the vital third quarter when they needed to be in this match. Only 2 points down at half-time. They just didn't have the players or the firepower to get themselves moving in that third quarter. Richmond went right away with the game. But North Melbourne now have kicked 7 goals in this last quarter to add some respectability.
And Richmond have kicked 8. Mark Arceri, 30 possessions and 4 goals. Out of the middle for North by Hepburn. And it comes the way of Fairley. And a mark on the forward line to Crocker. Well, at one stage, the Tigers led by about 13 goals. And now the margin is 9. Crocker can make it 8. And that will be one facet of Richmond's game that Kevin Bartlett won't be pleased with. Darren Crocker right in front. 25 metres from goal. And he pops it through, I think. Yes.
So Crocker now playing on the forward line as well. North Melbourne have made many changes throughout the afternoon to try to get some lift into the side. Hasn't been a bad player, Crocker. 13 kicks, 7 hand passes. Laffey caught under that one again. And Crocker taking the good, strong, solid mark.
A lot of goals in a losing side. 18. And that would be, as you said, Drew, a little bit worrying for Richmond to allow 18 when they've really dominated the second half. But they've relaxed a bit, Bernie.
Well, probably inexperience comes into it also, Peter.
Well, the margin is still 8 goals, and that's pretty decisive as Clarkson gets it out of the centre towards half forward. The mark has been taken by Tony Free. Off he goes. Hand pass. Good backing up by Richmond. Michael Thompson comes away from centre wing. Oh, Stuart Griffiths, the big fly over the back. Trevor Poole, brilliantly done. McRae to Angus, and North come away towards the forward line.
Kicked by Angus to half forward. Spargo, some sort of a hand pass back to Love, to Clarkson. Centering pass, Crocker's there again. McCarthy at the back. McCarthy, number 16, into Laffey, giving away the free kick. It's been 8 goals each in this last quarter. You don't often see 16 goals kicked in a quarter, and there's still 3 3/4 minutes to go. We could nearly get about 20 goals for a turn. Richmond out of defence. Egan marks behind centre wing.
Very strong overhead for such a short player, Phil Egan. Now, Matthew Knights. Oh, kicked his opponent out and took the mark, but it was a very clever little mark. He's pretty good overhead too for a rover. Onto the left foot went Knights. Straight up in the air. Oh, what a brilliant mark. What a great aerialist he is. That's Michael Pickering. The short one is on the left foot, and he's found his teammate down there in Alan McKellar. Alan McKellar will take this kick from almost on the boundary line. I bet he looks for a short one. He's only about 30 metres, 35 metres out. It's 17 kicks. He's been a good player. 24 possessions. Now he's going to have a shot from the line. He'll set it up towards full four. The high flyers are there. Mitchell was one of them, Jeff Hogg. He's been well held by Martin since going there. A good effort by Michael Martin.
Yes, goalless in this last quarter, Hogg, after 7 to 3/4 time. Just over 2.5 minutes left. Lounder missed it in the ruck, but might kick his fifth. Offline. Not bad agility. 4 goals, 2.
Yes, he does move well for a big man, Richard Lounder, and he'll keep getting better. But he's like a big rock of Gibraltar down there in that goal script. If you kick it high to him, he'd be a hard man to get around. It takes a tall man to play on him. Michael Martin towards half back.
Oh, the high flyer there with Brett Allison couldn't take it. Oh, attempt to kick off the ground, but Peter German, he's been a pretty quiet player today. A hand pass, a good one to Spargo, to Clarkson. Long, Crocker might mark this again. He just lent into his opponent, Laffey, and just outread him. Crocker from directly in front. Fantastic, bring some goals in this quarter.
Yeah, better use of the body there by Crocker. Kept Laffey out of the contest.
I reckon that's his position, full forward, Crocker, too. As he puts it, drifted away slightly, but it's a goal.
So two goals to Crocker since being moved to the forward line. And he's taken six marks, had 14 kicks and seven hand passes. That's one thing, you could play him anywhere, Crocker. He is a very versatile player. Clarkson kicking the ball long into the forward line. Good use of the body there by Crocker, taking that mark, keeping Laffey out, and then just sneaking that one through.
Well, the match has produced 45 goals. The last quarter, 17. And 28 players on the park have kicked goals. 10 for the Tigers and 8 for North Melbourne. Here goes Allison. Goes all the way. Kick off line. Crocker again. Well, North are lining up for their 10th goal for the quarter, which is not bad for a team which has been flogged.
Unbelievable. I don't think Kevin Bartlett would like this either.
Very difficult. Nearly jammed the ball between the posts. Straight across the face of goal. And out of bounds. Still over a minute left.
Well, the idea was right there to try and hook it back in, but he didn't get the angle on it. Just over a minute of play left. Alan McKellar on screen. I think they could do worse than play Crocker down there at full forward. He's got a lot of skill, and they certainly need someone down there with skill left. That was punched away in the air. There's Schwass getting it across now. I think that was Buckley coming in to have a shot. Now let's have a look. He has missed. But it was Ben Buckley, number 14. It's getting very dark here at the MCG. Time running out. 19-14 to 26-14. And that's seven goals the difference.
McKellar kicks in. The last half minute in the game. Oh, here's Schwass. And is that 10 goals for the quarter? It's got the distance. It gets there. Well, that's remarkable. Schwass has kicked four.
It's been a good quarter of football by North Melbourne. Although Richmond have kicked plenty themselves. They've kicked 8 goals. 10 goals to North Melbourne. That one's spilling to Schwass. Rather fortunate. And there he is kicking his fourth, but he's been a good player, a little bit quieter in this second half.
Well, you don't often see a game that produces 46 goals. There may be time left for one more. Bauer for the Tigers, up towards half forward. Martin charged straight at it and did that pretty well. 10 seconds left. Bauer after it again. The ball goes out of play, and that'll be it. Well, what an entertaining game of football, and the Tigers have hit back with a win here in round 5. 26-14, 170. North Melbourne, a great losing score, 20-14, 134.